Fortunately for the British, engineers were already working on another innovation, an explosive bullet that would rip holes in the gas bag wide enough to allow plenty of oxygen to rush in. This bullet would contain nitroglycerin, an explosive chemical sensitive to shock. When the bullet hit the canvas skin of the Zeppelin, it would slow down, but a steel ball inside would keep moving forward, compressing the nitroglycerin until it exploded, blowing a big hole in the gas bag. The air would rush in, and the oxygen would mix with the hydrogen to create an explosive cocktail of gases. If the flaming bullet entered the Zeppelin at this moment, it would have a good chance of sparking a fire. The British airmen were told to alternate the bullets when they loaded their machine gun magazines. It would take both rounds to bring down a Zeppelin.
They've now got the incendiary and the explosive bullet, and the pilots were instructed to mix their rounds and fire them alternately. And they'd alternate between incendiary and explosive. And the theory was if you fired enough of them into the aircraft, eventually he'll start a fire.
The first opportunity to try out the new ammunition was September 2nd, 1916, when the Germans launched the biggest raid of the war. A fleet of 16 airships set a course for London. British fighters were scrambled at 11 p.m. The first pilot into the air was 21-year-old William Leif Robinson. At 2:15 in the morning, one of the airships was caught in searchlights 12,000 feet above North London. Anti-aircraft guns opened fire.
The noise had been so intense that people started coming out of their houses, and up in the sky that they see this glowing monster, shells bursting all around it. They describe it as like stars twinkling in the sky, but it's shrapnel shells exploding.
Leif Robinson saw the cornered Zeppelin II and headed towards it. He had the airship at his mercy. He flew along the underside and fired a drum of his special bullets into it. To his dismay, they had no effect. Undeterred, he reloaded and went back in, but again, to no effect. In desperation and with just one drum of ammo left, he was forced to improvise. He concentrated his fire onto one spot, emptying the whole drum of bullets into the stern. By clustering the rounds into one area, the young pilot managed to open up a big enough hole for the oxygen to rush in. And the alternating bullets finally set the airship alight.
When the airship goes up, parents run in and drag their children from their beds. The cheers of the crowd were hard, merciless cheers. This was relief. The people were enjoying this moment. We're fighting back. As it hit the ground, railway engines were blowing the hooters. People started singing the national anthem. People were dancing and singing in the streets. The newspapers the next day described it as the greatest free show London has ever seen.
On the day that came to be known as Zepp Sunday, tens of thousands of relieved Londoners picked over the wreckage for souvenirs. Overnight, pilot William Leif Robinson became the most famous man in Britain. Babies, flowers, and hats were named after him, and he was mobbed wherever he went.